Refraction is the term used to describe the change in direction of a light wave due to a change in its transmission medium. In other words, when light comes in contact with certain surfaces, like water or glass, the light is bent or redirected because those surfaces affect the speed at which light travels through them. You can see a classic example of refraction by dipping a pencil into a bowl of water. The pencil will appear to bend or change directions at the spot where the pencil intersects the water. The illustration below shows how refraction works. X shows the true physical position of the pencil when it is dipped in water. The light rays from the submerged portion of the pencil are refracted at the air-water interface, changing speed and direction. From the camera's perspective, the pencil appears to bend at the surface of the water, with the tip appearing at position Y instead of its true position X. Let's see what is Index of Refraction or IOR. Index of Refraction or IOR is an optical measurement that describes the extent to which light is bent, or refracted, when it enters a particular material. Index of refraction can be measured, and real-world values for common surfaces are well known. When creating refractive materials in Unreal Engine, it is best to use real-world IOR values to give your materials a better sense of realism. The table below lists measured IOR values for some common surface types. Now let's use refraction in materials so we have a material made, in the name of refraction material. In the Details panel, change the blend mode from opaque to translucent. Expand the translucency section and change the lighting model from volumetric non-directional to surface translucency volume. Changing these settings will enable the refraction pin on the main material node. When completed, your details panel properties should look like this. Now add some material expression nodes, four constants, and convert two into scalar parameters. And name them as opacity and other one IOR. Begin wiring up the material. Change the constant value flowing into base color and metallic to 1. For parameters opacity, give it a default value of 0.3 and connect it to the opacity input. Parameter IOR as in its default value to 1.52, which is basically the IOR of glass. Your material graph should look like this. Find the refraction material asset in the content browser. Right-click on the thumbnail and select Create Material Instance from the context menu. Drop a few objects into your scene to test the material. Drag the refractive material underscore inst asset from the content browser onto the meshes in your scene. Double-click on the refraction material underscore inst to open it in the material instance editor. Enable the IOR parameter by checking the box next to the parameter name. Once enabled, you can set the IOR to different values to simulate different surface interaction. The video below shows how the refraction changes when the value is set to 1.0, air, 1.33, water, 1.52, glass, and 2.42, diamond. Refraction and normal maps. Adding an option to use a normal map with your refractive material will yield some very interesting results, especially in areas where the normal map has a lot of interesting detail. Follow the steps below to modify the refractive material created above so that it works with normal maps. First, find a normal map to use. For this example, T_water_n from starter content was used. However, any normal texture will work. Open the refraction material asset and drag the normal texture from the content browser into the material graph. Right-click on the normal map texture sampler and select Convert to Parameter. Rename the parameter normal map and connect it to the normal input on the main material node. By parameterizing the texture, You give artists a way to override it in a material instance without editing the parent material. In the material instance editor, you should now see the normal map parameter listed under global texture parameter values. You can override the normal map by enabling the parameter and choosing a different texture from the drop-down menu. By changing the normal map, you can change the material's refraction in interesting ways. Here are some examples using only the normal maps you can find in the textures folder of the starter content. Now let's see how refraction and movement together. Combining refraction with motion is a key component in many types of materials. Ripples on water are one example, but the technique is similarly useful in a lot of VFX materials such as heat haze, distortion from a large explosion, or energy effects. The graph below shows one way to add organic-looking motion to the normals. Duplicate the normal map, and connect them to the A and B inputs on a lerp node. Add two panner material expressions to the graph and connect them to the UVs of the normal map textures. Change the values in the panner nodes to add motion to the textures. Making some of the values negative moves the texture in the opposite direction, and is a good way to create organic, random-looking motion. Here are the values used for the two panners in this example. In its current state, it resembles an oily, metallic-looking fluid, but with some modifications it could be the basis for a water material. Adding refraction to your materials is a great way to get realistic-looking results for translucent materials like glass and water. Remember to consult the chart at the top of the document and use correct IOR values for the type of surface you are trying to simulate. Hope from this video, you will start to move into building in more advanced mechanics, in an easy-to-follow step-by-step approach, which will allow you to play around and build your own content, to eventually build your own game. Thanks a lot, see you in the next video.